L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is...
Hey, Gourmet GILF here, 2022. My old pal Doge is with us. And it's Valentine's Day, or not quite, but we're going to do a quick Valentine's Day meal. It's only going to take maybe 10, 15 minutes for the whole thing. It's swordfish, asparagus. We have a nice salad made out of spinach and everything to go with it. So it's going to be doggone fast, what I have here. Oh, while we're at it, look at this new kitchen. We put in a butcher block countertop. My good friend Tom did it. And then the backsplash and all that. Just try to dress it up a little bit here and there. So, I guess we're going to go here. First off, I'm going to warm up these pans. And we're using cast iron. And now if you're using stainless steel, remember this is going to hold the heat a lot longer than your stainless steel or your Teflon pans. So, it's going to be a little bit difference in cooking here, right? So, a little bit of oil. We're waiting for our oil to heat up. We'll see our smoke. This is a grapeseed oil, and it's got a different smoke point than olive oil. And the reason is, it's just different oils, and it's we're gonna have a little bit of smoke here. Over here, we are gonna start getting our seasoned pepper. Okay, salt. I like lemon pepper on mine. Okay. Pack it in a little bit. I know why they call it rub. It should be called pat. Over we go. This is called blood trail. If it's brown, a lot of brown in it, just cut it out. But it doesn't stink. It's quite edible. Okay. And sides, of course, right? Just pat everything with the sides. Pretty close enough, right, Linz?
Yeah.
Okay, now, butter. And we want to get our asparagus in ASAP also. See our oil? Hasn't quite started to smoke yet, but that's okay on the asparagus. We don't need to really smoke on the asparagus, but butter. And if you never had swordfish, I'll buy it all the time up the hill. Beef anymore, like we could have done steak, but I'm gonna refinance my house for a couple steaks on Valentine's Day. It's not gonna happen. That stuff's getting very expensive. But pork and chicken and fish are still kind of reasonable. And we go this way. Our asparagus is going to take probably just as long to cook as our swordfish. Let's get that in there. And we got a little bit of garlic here we're going to use. We're not going to burn our garlic. We're going to watch it close. We just want to brown it. If it gets too out of control, we just take it out of there. Oh, we got sizzle. That's a good sound right there. What we're going to do is salt that a little bit and a little bit of pepper. That should be enough with our garlic. Try to get them in there somehow. Okay. Now, how are we doing here? Not quite. Oh, quite. And I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but this is a Valentine's Day video, and it's a very fast dish to make for Valentine's Day for two. You'll see. Salad, asparagus, swordfish. The swordfish is only going to cook for probably 3 to 5 minutes on each side. As soon as you put it on, do not move it around. You're going to wait about 2, maybe 3 minutes
And then you can start moving it around a little bit. If you have to add more oil, by all means. If you want to add more butter, go ahead. We'll catch you in about, I don't know, what do you think? Huh? So Valentine's Day, the history of Valentine's is that in 200 AD or whatever, a Roman emperor named Caligula had a big old army and needed more men, because they're getting their hind ends waxed by the Goths, right? And so in order to stay out of the army, you had to be married. You'd have to go. Well, and so everybody's getting married, and he didn't have the men he wanted. And so this St. Valentine's guy was secretly marrying all these people. Well, Caligula got wind of it, and he said, hey, Valentine, you dipstick, we're going to arrest you straight behind bars. Well, the jailer's daughter fell in love with this Valentine guy, and he sent a note out to her from your Valentine. Well, on February 14th, they clipped him, and there you go. Pretty deep, right, Lindsay?
That's really deep.
You mean the story or my, me? Is it deep? You mean manure type deep, or what are you saying? Is that what you're saying?
Probably, yeah.
But don't be a Karen. It's Valentine's Day. All right, here we go. You start moving your fish around a little bit, right? Because we waited, otherwise it would have stuck. Okay, it's about a third done down there, and when it gets white all the way, we're going to flip it. And you're going to see the gold brown coming, and that's what we're going to want. It's gold brown on both sides, right? And then we're going to add a little bit of lemon juice. Oh, we made a mess over here. And we're going to slice up what's left of the lemons and put on top when we get done, when we flip the fish, okay? So, lemon juice.
Good dog and love is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made.
And we're going to turn off the heat because this, like I told you before, is a cast iron pan that's going to hold heat for a long, long time. You see, we're all white through here. We're done, just waiting for the bob to crisp up a little bit. And if you are kind of want everything crisp up, just turn your fish over and do the sides if you want them brown. I don't care one way or the other. It doesn't matter to me. But you can do it that way also, right? Our asparagus is done. So we can shut off that pan also. Like I say, the cast iron will hold the heat. And we can sprinkle some Parmesan cheese on that. We didn't dice any up. We want something a fast meal. And that's what we have here. I don't know how long that took. We have to eyeball it on the film. What do you say, 10 minutes tops?
I don't know.
Well, the preparation took a minute. So, you know. Anyway, we are about done. We're going to plate this up and see what we got. We'll be back with you in a second. Gourmet GILF back, Valentine's Day 2022. We got our swordfish done. We got our nice little salad here. It's got peppers, cherry tomatoes, peppercinis, mushrooms, and that's about it. Spinach. I think we're cooked. Oh yeah, just dry. And our swordfish. So let's try it and wish everybody a happy Valentine's Day. And look at that. Bueno. Oh, that's very good. I love swordfish. And it's reasonably priced. You can go up on the hill and get it. We'd like to thank our truckers, our police, our military, and all our friends. It's been a long time since we've had a video out. We do now. We're going to do as many as we can. We have to catch up, right, Lindsay?
Mm-hmm.
And happy Valentine's Day, everybody. See you next time.
It's even more than anyone that you adore can love.